Hi, it's Michael from the Red Chair Diaries, Bedford, Nova Scotia, and it is the 3rd of November, 2010. I'm sitting here in the library. I've only got one side light on. That's why this the coloration, I think, is actually quite interesting. I wore my orangey-ready sweater because it does get cool down here, and I've already got the fireplace on for the cat. I've got Bob in here by my side. So it's a nice space to be, dust and all. Just a short few words tonight. I'm disappointed in the way the House of Representatives in the United States has turned out. That's, you know, like I say, the Republicans don't run to please me. I'm north of the border. I am glad the Democrats held on to the Senate. I think sometimes it's really hard to get legislation through when you have that situation, but at the same time, it is that balance that can be good. Again, surprised about California that there weren't more people in favor of marijuana. Now, but when you really think about it, you know, you've got that base in San Francisco, maybe, and you've got that base in Los Angeles and San Diego, and maybe near the border of Mexico. But you know, California is where Ronald Reagan was the governor. You know, and there's a lot of conservatives down there, out there in those coastal towns and in those mountains and in Northern California. I mean, if you're going to be next to Oregon, you've got a very, very interesting mixture of fundamentalists and Republicans and conservatives up there, you know. So not everybody's running around San Francisco going to gay clubs and, you know, toking up with Bill Mayer at studios in Los Angeles. But it sure could have helped the tax base down there. I mean, the state is basically bankrupt from what I remember. So people don't pay attention to history like they're supposed to, you know, so they repeat these things that if it ceased to be prohibited, it would sure help loosen up some dollars down there that could be used for proper police work instead of just the dumb stuff, you know, that money gets wasted on and prisons get wasted on and all of that sort of stuff. So much for that rant, right? I didn't even know I was going to talk about this, but I just want to say that I'm 59 in, what is it, the 3rd? Yeah, 8 days from now, I guess. 11th. No, 8 days in a month. The 11th of December. And here I am going for a job interview on Friday, of all things. So I was glad to get a call from one of the colleges to take a part-time job to do some work with distance education and, you know, helping students on the phone and things like that. So let's see what happens with that. I sure hope I get it because it would make the difference, mean the difference between being comfortable and being, you know, kind of struggling every month, you know. But I'm very lucky that I do have my pension from my former government job. It's not like I'm not going to be on the streets anytime soon. But, you know, things it's always tight now at the end of the month. Anyway, so for those of you who believe in God, you can pray for me. And for those of you like me who don't, just say, geez, I hope he gets it, you know, and see how it works out. Anyway, that's it. So don't need anything bigger in your head, and we'll take it from there. I'll let you know how it goes next week.